So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. I am Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session, as usually, we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are new here, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, right? And discuss your link here, you will get in the description. So let's begin with the very first question, which says you have to consider the following statements regarding the Startup India Seed Fund and identify the correct statements. So एक Startup India Seed Fund scheme है जो कि government ने launch करी है, उसके regarding you have to identify the correct statements out of these three, right? And question number two is also based on this scheme, so let's discuss about the scheme first. So the government has launched Startup India Seed Fund scheme to provide financial assistance to those startups who usually do not get any financial support from the investors. ऐसे startups जहाँ पे investors का support ज़्यादा नहीं होता, उन startups को support provide कराने के लिए this Startup India Seed Fund scheme has been launched by the government. And the example of these startups, guys, are the water management, biotechnology, and defence. So जो इन sectors के स्टार्टअप्स होते हैं उनको ज्यादा इन्वेस्टर्स से बेनिफिट नहीं मिलता, ज्यादा इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं मिलती. सो फॉर दैट दिस स्कीम हैज बीन लॉन्च एंड द टोटल आउटले फॉर दिस स्कीम इज 945 करोड़ फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 5 इयर्स. व्हाइल फॉर दिस ईयर द टोटल एलोकेटेड फंड इज हाउ मच रुपीज 126 करोड़. इस साल के लिए कितना, 126 करोड़. व्हाइल ओवरऑल 5 इयर्स के लिए इट इज 945 करोड़. एंड रिमेंबर द स्कीम विल बी इंप्लीमेंटेड फ्रॉम 1st ऑफ अप्रैल 2021 व्हिच इज the very first day of the financial year 2022, right? Now what is the implementation plan of this scheme? किस तरीके से implement की जाएगी ये scheme और इसमें किस तरीके से support provide कराया जाएगा? Let's discuss about this. So the startups and incubators will be chosen by an expert committee. एक expert committee होगी. It will select the startups and incubators of the and this committee guys will be selected by the Department for Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. DPIIT द्वारा एक कमेटी बनाई जाएगी and that committee will select the eligible startups and incubators to provide the support. Alright. Now what incubators will do? So they will provide rupees 20 lakh up to rupees 20 lakh to the startups for validation of the prototype development and up to rupees 50 lakh for market entry and commercialization. Alright. So जो incubators हैं उनको क्या वो उनके क्या responsibility है? So they will provide up to rupees 20 lakh to the startups for prototype development, while up to rupees 50 lakh for market entry and commercialization. Alright. Now what they will get, उनको क्या मिलेगा? So they will be provided up to rupees 5 crore by the government. Okay. So जो incubators हैं उनको क्या मिलेगा? Up to 5 crore रुपए मिलेंगे and in turn they will provide this support to the startups. Alright. And there is one condition also, this is very important condition, that the startup should not have received monetary support of up to rupees 10 lakh, more than rupees 10 lakh under any other central or state government scheme. Agar kisi startup ne 10 lakh se zyada ka fund, 10 lakh se zyada ka financial support already le rakha hai under any central or state government scheme, then that startup will not be eligible to get the benefit under this scheme. Alright. So I hope guys this scheme is clear, and now let's come back to the question, and here you have to identify the correct statements. This scheme aims to provide early stage funding to those startups which usually do not attract investments. Yes, this is absolutely correct, and the example of these sectors is biotechnology, defense. Total outlay is rupees 945 crores for 5 years, this is absolutely correct, and for this year it is 126 crores. The scheme will be implemented from 1st April 2021. This is also absolutely correct, which means all the statements are correct. Therefore, option E, all are correct, will be the correct answer, because we have to identify the correct statement. And as I told you, ki aapko is word pe dhyan rakhna hai, whether you have to identify the correct statement or the incorrect, right? And question number 2, how much amount of grants will be provided to the eligible incubators under the Startup India Seed Fund scheme? So, jo incubators hain, unko kitna paisa milega by the government? The question is this, so they will get how much rupees? 5 crores. 5 crore rupees incubators ko diye jayenge, and these incubators will provide up to rupees 20 lakh for prototype development to the startups and up to rupees 50 lakhs for their market entry. Alright. So I hope guys this news is clear, and now let's come to question number 3. Where was the India's first Center for Wetlands Conservation and Management established? भारत का पहला Center for Wetland Conservation and Management established हुआ है. Question is कहाँ पे established हुआ है? Okay, this is very important question and remember it was established on the World Wetlands Day, which is of course on 2nd of February. 2nd of February and this year the theme was Wetlands and Water. Wetlands and water, and for the wetlands we have a convention also, which we all know is Ramsar Convention, and Ramsar of course is a place in Iran. All right, so let's discuss about this news. So a dedicated center for wetland conservation and management has been established at another center. Aur ye kaun sa center hai? That is the National Center for Sustainable Coastal Management, which is located in Chennai. So we have a National Center for Sustainable Coastal Management in Chennai. Under that campus, a new center for wetland conservation and management has been established by Babul Supriyo, who is BJP member of parliament. And this center, guys, will assist the national and the state governments in designing and implementation of the policy related to the wetlands conservation and its management. जो वेटलैंड का कंजर्वेशन है, उसका मैनेजमेंट है, उससे रिलेटेड जो भी पॉलिसी होगी, उसको किस तरीके से डिजाइन किया जाएगा, उसको किस तरीके से इंप्लीमेंट किया जाएगा, दिस सेंटर विल प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट टू द सेंट्रल गवर्नमेंट एंड द स्टेट गवर्नमेंट रिगार्डिंग दैट. राइट, सो इसमें हमें इतना ही पढ़ना है. सो देयरफॉर द करेक्ट आंसर इज व्हाट, ऑप्शन ए चेन्नई, एंड चेन्नई ऑफ कोर्स इज इन तमिलनाडु द कैपिटल. एंड नाउ लेट्स मूव अहेड टू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. Consider the following statements regarding National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board, and you have to identify the correct statement. Now, first of all, the question is why we are discussing about this board. हम इस board के बारे में, the National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Board के बारे में क्यों पढ़ रहे हैं? What is the reason? So the reason is that the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare, who is also the Minister of Earth Sciences, and he is also the Minister of Science and Technology, Dr. Harshvardhan. Has submitted a reply in Rajya Sabha regarding the functioning of this National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board. Okay, so let's talk about this board. So remember, it was established in the year 1982. And can you tell me the name of an organization which was established on 12th of July 1982? Write down in the comments. 12th of July 1982 को एक बहुत important organization India के establish हुई थी. Write down the name of that organization in the comments. And it was also established in 1982 under the Department of Science and Technology. Okay, and Department of Science and Technology will complete 50 years in 2021. This board has the objective of promoting knowledge-driven and technology-intensive enterprises, and it will also act as a policy supporter for the government of India in the field of technology-driven enterprises. Okay, basically, ये इंडिया जो government of India है, उसको support provide कराता है in the in formulating the policies regarding the technology intensive enterprises. All right, and this NSTDEB, or we can say the National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board, is implementing two very important programs, which one is Nidhi program and another is Kavach. Okay, दो बहुत important program है जो कि ये organization implement कर रहा है. Let's talk about these programs. So first of all, if we talk about the Nidhi program, so Nidhi stands for National Initiative for Developing and Harnessing Innovations. दोनों जो programs हैं, Nidhi और Kavach, ये दोनों basically startups के लिए हैं, because जो ये board है, इसका काम ही startups को develop करना है. So Nidhi program, Nidhi stands for National Initiative for Developing and Harnessing Innovation, and through this program, technology business incubators are provided support in the academic institutions. जो हमारे देश के academic institutions हैं, वहां पे टेक्नोलॉजी बिजनेस इंक्यूबेटर्स को सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराया जाता है थ्रू दिस निधि प्रोग्राम. एंड दीज टेक्नोलॉजी बिजनेस इंक्यूबेटर्स प्रोवाइड सपोर्ट टू द स्टार्टअप्स फॉर टेकिंग इनोवेशन प्रोडक्ट्स टू द मार्केट. राइट, ये जो टेक्नोलॉजी बिजनेस इंक्यूबेटर्स है, ये क्या करते हैं? स्टार्टअप्स को सपोर्ट देते हैं ताकि जो उनका इनोवेटिव प्रोडक्ट्स है वो मार्केट तक पहुंच सके. ओके, एंड टॉकिंग अबाउट द कवच इनिशिएटिव, so Kavach stands for Center for Augmenting War on COVID-19 Health Crisis. इसमें भी बेसिकली स्टार्टअप्स को ही प्रमोट किया गया था, और ऐसे स्टार्टअप्स जो कि हेल्थ के सेक्टर से रिलेटेड थे, एंड ऐसे स्टार्टअप्स जिन्होंने COVID-19 से रिलेटेड किसी भी चीज में, किसी भी फील्ड में काम किया है. सो टोटल 51 स्टार्टअप्स विद COVID-19 मार्केट रेडी सॉल्यूशंस हैव बीन सपोर्टेड अंडर द 5 थीमेटिक एरियाज. एंड व्हाट आर दीस 5 थीमेटिक एरियाज? डायग्नोस्टिक इन्फॉर्मेटिक्स, स्टेरिलाइजर्स एंड डिसइंफेक्टेंट्स, पीपीई किट, वेंटिलेटर एंड रेस्पिरेटरी केयर डिवाइसेस. ओके, सो दीज आर द फाइव थीमेटिक एरिया जिसमें कवच प्रोग्राम के थ्रू स्टार्टअप्स को सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराया जाता है बाय द नेशनल साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट बोर्ड. ओके, सो नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 4. सो यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई द करेक्ट स्टेटमेंट्स रिगार्डिंग दिस बोर्ड. It was established in 1972 under the Department of Science and Technology. So is that 1972? No, that's 1982 when it was established. So the statement is incorrect. NSTDEB, National Science and Technology, it should be EDB. It should be EDB. NSTEDB is implementing the NIDHI program under which technology incubators are provided support. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Through the NIDHI program, this board is providing support to the technology business incubators, which in turn provide support to the startups for promoting their products in the market. Through the coverage program of this board, 51 startups have been provided support under 5 thematic areas related to COVID-19. Yes, this is also correct. So we have two statements which are correct here. So option B, only 2 and 3 guys will be the correct answer. Okay, and guys, this is very important because this development board ke baare mein isse bahut pehle एक बार जिक्र हुआ था, रिसेंट में इसका कोई जिक्र नहीं है. सो इसका जिक्र किया गया, सो वी कैन एक्सपेक्ट अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द एग्जाम आल्सो, राइट? सो दैट्स इट फॉर दिस सेशन गाइस. आई होप ऑल द क्वेश्चंस आर क्लियर. इफ यू हैव एनी डाउट्स यू कैन आस्क मी इन द कमेंट सेशन. और जो भी आपकी प्रिपरेशन हो चुकी है, कीप रिवाइजिंग इट. थैंक यू सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग. गुड बाय, टेक केयर एंड गॉड ब्लेस.